Conker has actually had a tiny spike in population on X-Link Kai since the game was added onto the Xbox One. For the first time in 8 years, the game saw a full 16-player game and had players on it for a few days on end, even getting the attention of veteran players such as Taiwo, Tito Matic, yes, the actual MLG player, he's a fucking god at this game too, Ron and a few others. But for the most part, a lot of new players we got, not trying to come off as offensive or anything like that, don't really know how to play the game. So I'm probably gonna start releasing little tip videos like these for those players who are just picking up the game. Because let's be honest, you're only gonna have more fun on the game once you learn how to play it at least a little bit better by learning the basics. So it seems like a lot of the things first timers have a hard time with is destroying objectives or vehicles. They tend to use the wrong things that won't cause any damage to said target. So for each class in order of best to worst in terms of DPS, here are the things you use to damage objectives or vehicles. For this test, I didn't really take into account ease of access or most situations or anything too deep like that. You know, I ain't trying to scare you guys off with daunting amounts of fucking information. You know, I'm just trying to cover the basics. So yeah, I just used the first blockade for this test on Beach Dead to test out DPS. Also, I only tested this out with one bot in the game, and if you didn't know, how much punishment an objective is able to take in this game is actually solely dependent on the amount of people in the lobby. So for example, the less people, the weaker the objectives are, and vice versa. So first off, we're starting off with the Demolisher. Just as his name implies, can pretty much harm vehicles and objectives with just about anything he has besides his napalm and smoke grenades. Those two grenades, along with Magnovas and gas grenades, don't harm objectives or vehicles. However, the gas grenade can harm the driver inside the vehicle. The best weapon the Demolisher can use to destroy these targets is his minigun. Ooh, minigun. You don't spawn with this weapon, however. It's one of those guns you can only get through an upgrade. But yeah, it's easily the best tool to destroy stuff for the Demolisher. It absolutely decimates the first blockade in just 6 seconds. However, if you're up against a Sky Jockey, then the best option would probably be your Fire and Forget rocket. For those who don't know, these are heat-seeking missiles. They only work on aircrafts, though, so if you ever wondered why it wasn't there on maps that ban the Sky Jockey, that's why. Next up, you have the Thermophile. By holding the left trigger, you can bring up a mini menu showing you the types of ammo you can use. This is also the same for holding Y for weapons to bring up additional items, and the same for holding X to see additional abilities. And if you tap the button, you can quickly cycle through each of the main items with the exception of your special abilities, which is the X button. Tapping X will just enable whatever special ability you're currently on. Thermos can't harm objectives or vehicles with fire, but if you tap L, you'll switch to acid, which can harm those specific targets. But the best option a thermo has is his laser, which can easily destroy the first blockade in just 8 seconds. Just like the demo's minigun though, getting your hands on a laser means finding an upgrade. And then after that, we have the sneaker. You would think sneakers can't do much since they're mostly good at close range, but sneakers, much like demolishers, can do damage with just about anything they have. Slices from both attack and defense mode can harm both objectives and vehicles. Although I wouldn't advise ever trying to slash an oncoming vehicle for obvious reasons. The sneaker's best tools against these things are throwing knives and snoopas. With a combination of the two, a sneaker can down the first blockade in about the same time as a thermophile, clocking in at just 8 seconds. Something to keep in mind though is that a snoopa can only travel so far, so you'll have to be a little close to get a snoopa where you want it to be. And also, to get your hands on a dagger, you're gonna have to get an upgrade for that. Next up, we have the Long Ranger. This class would have easily been first on the list if we had access to Xbox Live's unlockables, because with a significantly decreased charge time, Long Rangers can fully charge their shots in about 2 seconds at most, which is a massive cut down from the current 7 seconds without the unlock. A Long Ranger can damage objectives and vehicles with a sniper, but only when switched to DU tip. They can also do damage with their secondary as well, but a sniper is definitely to go to, as they can down the first blockade in 13 seconds, combining a fully charged shot, a mid-charged shot, and 2 weak ones. And lastly, we have the Grunt, the slowest one on this list in terms of DPS on objectives and vehicles. The Grunt can cause damage to these things with its primary, but only after switching the dum-dum shots. In other words, single fire. He can also use his grenade launcher, although the long reload time and its slow speed definitely doesn't make it that good in terms of destroying objectives. Using a combination of these two, the Grunt more or less takes around 20 seconds to destroy the first blockade. And then, I mean, if you really want to cover this one, there's the Sky Jockey. But that one is easily the worst unless you have an aircraft. Other than that, just like grunts, sky jockeys can only harm objectives and vehicles using single fire. Then there's their Magnova grenade, which is an outlier since sky jockeys' Magnovas are the only Magnovas that can do damage. That pretty much wraps up this basic tutorial though. Now you guys can go into PvP and actually put in some work instead of looking dumb like these biased ass IGN reviewers over here.
The multiplayer really isn't that great. It's not so much that it's bad, it's just, it's not that much fun. A lot of thought went into it. It's a class-based multiplayer, so...
Seriously, how the fuck did this guy even get this job? But yeah, I got more basic Conker tutorials like these in the works, because from what I've seen over the years, new players end up leaving pretty quick because they don't really know what to do. So they're not able to play the game much, and as a result, get bored and leave. And then this game never really had videos or tutorials with this kind of info. It was usually kept a secret by a select few players, and was only ever spread through word of mouth to other players they felt were worthy. That's why this game probably has the biggest skill gap I've ever seen. Not because the players were fundamentally better, I mean sometimes that was the case, but who's to say how much closer the skill gap would have been if players weren't holding back info. So this time around we're gonna help new players out, cause it's the new players who are gonna keep the game alive. We also got a Discord server, I'll put that in the description if you guys are looking to get into the game. And if you got any specific things you need help with, hit up the comments and I got you bro. But yeah, other than that, good luck and hopefully we'll see you on Conker on X-Link.